in to kick this one off. Booming kick downfield. From the 1 yard line. This play will be the first of the game for the offense. It's first and 10.
Start the drive at the 30-yard line. First and 10.
Hey, watch the screen.
Minnesota comes out in their nickel pack.
Here we go, baby. Clear. Clear.
Under pressure with a deep throw to the right side. It's broken up.
That was a pretty good throw, and the receiver was able to get to it. He just couldn't close the deal and bring it in for the catch.
Second and 10. Ball on the 30-yard line.
The Vikings with a four-man front.
Defense, get ready. Watch this.
Hands it off. Wright is there for the tackle at the 32-yard line.
Mixon runs with passes, keeps the defense on.
And they'll face a long third down here. Minnesota comes out in their nickel package. Closing in, steps up into the pocket. What a tremendous individual effort by the defensive lineman.
And that's the kind of defensive player you can build a team around. Having a guy like that up front allows you to drop seven or eight guys back in coverage and still get a pass rush.
Number 42 is back to receive this kick. From the 22-yard line. Pretty good return, and they stop him at the 37. Ball on their own 37.
At the 37-yard line. First and 10.
They give it to the halfback. Marshall is there on the stop. He tried to pick his way through the middle, but there was no room.
That's right. And when the middle of your offensive line is eaten up like that, you got to try and get to the outside. But they wouldn't let him get away.
Ball on their own 37.
Ball on the 37-yard line.
8 defenders in the box on this one.
Let's go now. Here we go. Here we go.
Gets the pass off. He hits his receiver. He puts something extra on that throw that keeps the chains down.
Yeah, he can really fire it in there when he needs to.
Ball right around midfield.
49-yard line.
Going to the air on first down. With the throw, and it's caught. Frazier is there for the tackle at the 41-yard line.
A successful offense is one that can run and throw for good yardage on first down.
Second and short.
Ball on the 41-yard line.
Keep the throttle down.
Number 10 will work out of the shotgun. The rush is on. Gets the pass off. Frazier stops him at the 33. Number 82 makes his second catch for a first down on this drive.
First and 10. Ball on the 33-yard line.
The Vikings line up in trips bunch. Pass play here on first down. Throws it. They'll knock him out of bounds at the 25.
I like the quick decision by the quarterback. The defense didn't have time to react.
And that's a gain of about 8. Ball on the 25-yard line.
Ball on the 25-yard line.
Here we go, baby.
Chicago comes out in their nickel pack. Dropping back. Throwing. And it's complete. Singletary records the stop at the 21-yard line. Number 10 with a hot hand on this drive.
Let's see what they can do in the red zone.
Foreman, the lone back. Gets the pass off. Right on target to the wide receiver. And Brady, too, with another catch and a first down.
Yeah, they've gone to him five times in this drive. The defense can't keep letting one guy beat him.
6 more yards and they'll put up 6. They'll go from the I formation. Number 10 with a man in motion. Number 73 gets right in there and brings him down. His excellent positioning led to that stop behind the line of scrimmage.
And he'll do that kind of thing. He's one of the smartest players at defensive end. He always seems to be in position and uses his hands well, and he has those long arms. And that really helps him shed blockers.
Chicago comes out in a 4-3. A little misdirection. Singletary comes up to make the play. At the 7. Good job knifing in there to bring him down.
He brings a lot of things to the table. But the thing I like the most is how prepared he always is. I mean, he can run and he can tackle. And he watches so much tape that he actually anticipates what the offense is going to run before they call the play.
Number 10 with split backs. Looking to run it here. Can't pull him down. And they're in. Touchdown. Phillips appears to have sustained an injury and will make his way to the sideline under his own power. Cox comes in for the extra point. The point after is good.
They did everything they had to on that one. And the end result was a trip across the goal line and a TD on the board.
From the 3-yard line.
It's still early in the game, but you got to think the coach wants his guys to make the statement by scoring some points in this drive.
The Bears will start the drive at the 25-yard line. First and 10.
The Vikings with a 4-man front.
Play football.
Tosses it left. He's brought down behind the line for a short loss. You know, Johnny always seems to be in perfect position to make a play.
He's all about effort. His motor's always running at 100%, and he's got the experience to diagnose plays very quickly.
Second and 11. Ball on the 25-yard line.
It's on. Let's go.
Minnesota goes with a 4-man front. They give it to the halfback. Number 50 makes the tackle at the 33.
You never know when you're going to find some room and break loose into the secondary.
Ball on their own 33.
Ball on the 33-yard line.
Hey, watch the screen.
The Vikings come out in a nickel package. Play on third and short. With the pass, he finds his man.
He's one of those guys who can really run. They have plays designed around him in their offensive game plan.
Ball right around midfield. We've reached the end of the first quarter, and the score is 7-0.
Minnesota
Vikings.
7. Chicago. Nothing.
And we're ready to start the second quarter.
Ball is midfield.
Ball on the 49-yard line.
The Vikings line up in a 4-3. They give it to the halfback. Nice play fake. Fires this one deep. The pass falls incomplete.
A little too much touch. Word from the sideline now about the injury. Apparently he did not hurt his hand that badly. And we're being told we may see him back in the game with a splint on him.
Tucks it away. Pressure dragged down from behind.
Covering guys downfield is a good way to get pressure on the quarterback. If he can't find someone downfield, then he has to throw it away, hold it, or pull it down quickly. Or the pass rushers will be right there to haul him down.
It's now third and long after the sack.
42-yard line.
Tate, the long setback. Pressure coming. Long throw. This one falls incomplete.
Good timing getting in between the ball and the receiver to save what would have been a big game.
Number 8 comes into the game for the punt. Number 42 sets up, waiting for the punt. This one goes out of bounds. Ball on their own 35.
Ball on the 35-yard line.
Let's go. Watch out.
The Bears come out in a dive package. Under pressure, throwing. Drops the interception.
Dawson was the one they were trying to get the ball to. Number 22 with the coverage.
Phillips was taken out earlier with a minor injury, but now returns to the game. They're looking for the run with all those linebackers out there.
They need some better blocking out of that offensive front. You have to use your hands to get them out in front of you, keep them inside, maintain leverage and balance that you need to hold those blocks and slow down the pass rush.
Ball on their own 30.
Ball on the 30-yard line.
Only one man back. Closing in. Down he goes. A great stop by the defense.
Yeah, they really had the plays perfectly defended. And they were able to move him back.
Very solid defensive effort to force the three and out. Right through his hands. The Bears are there to pick up the ball. And you know, the defense is very angry at that missed opportunity. Ball on their own 34. Going to the air on first down. Gets the pass off. Number 58 is there for the tackle at the 45. John, he's proven he's a consistent target.
Yeah, especially in situations where they're looking to get first down yardage.
Ball on their own 45.
Ball on the 45-yard line.
Hold them up!
Minnesota using three linebackers. Missed tackle. Number 50 is there on the stop at the 46-yard line.
A successful running attack requires good blocking up front to be effective.
Second and one. Ball on the 46-yard line.
Watch your man. He didn't have one.
The Vikings line up at a 4-3. Stiff arms the defender to the ground. He broke a tackle in the backfield and got the first down.
Yeah, great play by the defender getting in the backfield, but he didn't wrap him up.
First and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line.
Let's go now. Here we go.
Minnesota goes with a four-man front. Gives the ball off.
The defense held their positions and didn't let him get very far.
Gain of about a yard. Second and nine coming up here.
Here we go, baby.
The Vikings with a four-man front. Number 90 is there for the tackle at the 39-yard line. So let's take a look at how this back compares to the opposition. Two-minute warning coming up.
All on us, y'all.
Minnesota comes out in their nickel package with the throw. Johnson makes the catch. And he fights off the defender to make the catch for a big game. Almost at the two-minute mark now. It's first and goal at the one. Gets the call. Great fake. Soft lob to the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. And so just like that, pass, catch, touchdown. Butler will attempt the extra point that would tie this game up. The point after is good.
Big players make big plays, and that scores touchdowns. Give some credit to the linemen out there. They're the biggest guys in the field, and without them, no one gets into the end zone.
This one is taken by Bryant. The force of three and out on the offense's last possession. Ball on their own 27.
First and 10.
The Bears come out in a nickel package. Pump faking. Steps up into the pocket. Singletary is there on the stop at the 31.
Here's a no-huddle. It's a good way to keep the defense off balance.
Here we go.
Drops back. Pressure. Can't avoid the rush. Great job getting in there to drag the quarterback down, and he picks up the sack.
And he'll make two or three plays like that in just about every game.
Pressure coming. Chicago calls a timeout. They have one timeout left. They take another sack, and that brings up fourth down.
They shot through there and used both moves and power to disrupt the play and get that sack.
Good defensive stand there. Now they'll punt it away after a three and out. Fair catch.
Fair catch made at the 31-yard line. The Bears will start the drive at the 31-yard line. First and 10.
The Vikings come out in a nickel package.
Let's go. Be fierce.
They're coming with the blitz. With the throw, he had a shot but couldn't come up with it.
He put the ball exactly where you want to put it. As a defensive lineman, you love this because you know they're going to be passing. So you don't worry about a play pass or a handoff or anything like that. You just rush the passer. Hey, don't think the quarterback doesn't know that, because he'll let the ball fly before he gets sacked by one of those guys.
McMahon sends a man in motion.
Hey, let's go.
Dropping back. Under pressure. Gets rid of it. Running with a lot of room in front. The defender goes down. How about that speed? Great individual effort by Peyton.
Hey, that's all you have to do with this guy. Just give him the ball and let him outrun everybody on the field. I like to hurry up here. It's a change of pace, and it's a way to get the defense uncomfortable.
Throws it, and the catch is made. Number 50 is there for the tackle at the 34-yard line.
What they're doing here is keeping the defense from huddling up. It keeps the same defense on the field.
The rush is on. Looking long down the right side of the field. Trying for the end zone before halftime. Oh, man, he had it in the end zone, but dropped it.
One person breathing a sigh of relief is the quarterback.
Minnesota using three linebackers. Going to the right. Number 58 is there on the stop at the 28. And here's what they've been able to do so far on third down. Closing in, looking for the deep pass down the right side.
Watch it here. He's getting pressure, but he's strong enough and mobile enough to get away from the rush and avoid the sack. Now, you need a quarterback who can do things like that, because sometimes an incompletion can be a pretty good play.
Good. Chicago now leads for the first time in the game.
This is a team that's very balanced. They don't think too much about the score in the first part of the game. They just keep going out and do their thing.
Butler Chicago comes in to kick off.
Lined up for the kickoff. Ryan back to return.
This one is fielded by Bryant. Puts it on the ground. The Bears scoop up the fumble. Trying to get something started, he ends up turning it over on the kickoff.
And the thing is, they've got their wedge busters down there, and everyone else is flying down the field trying to make a play. And somebody ends up putting a big hit on that return man.
Ball on the 16-yard line.
I thought he was down, and then the ball popped loose, but it's difficult to tell from this angle.
And mostly the official is seeing what we're seeing. So it's inconclusive. The call will stand, since he needs to be 100% sure to overturn a call.
No fumble occurred.
It was unclear initially why they called for a review, but now we understand the reason.
You have to give it to these officials. Their job's not easy. Sometimes they make mistakes, and most of the times they're right.
Carroll, the man in motion, hand it off. Singletary comes up to make the play at the 19.
This team's always trying to get a good mix of run and pass plays.
1 yard gain on that play.
Second
ball on their own 19.
Ball on the 19-yard line.
Watch out.
One of us will make a play.
The Bears line up in a 4-3. Pressure, throws it. He hits his receiver. Number 45 is there on the stop at the 21-yard line. Number 82 goes down after a minimal gain. Ball on their own 21.
Ball on the 21-yard line.
Foreman lines up behind his fullback in the eye. They're coming with the blitz. Steps up into the pocket.
This team is extremely active on defense, whether it's flowing from sideline to sideline or when they're rushing a passer. Maybe they should keep a couple extra guys in the block just to slow this pass rush down.
Number 11 will come in now to punt it away. Gentry back to return. He muffs it. The Vikings pick up the fumble. He can't field the punt and it winds up in the kicking team's hands.
Some returners, not all of them, have a tendency to peek at defenders running downfield. And when they do that, you'll find they lose the ball.
And they're ready to go on offense after that fumble. They'll start at the 32-yard line. The Bears come out in a nickel pack. They're blitzing. The Vikings call a timeout. They have no timeouts left. They'll take another snap.
I'm not sure why he held the ball so long. You've got to get rid of it. Throw it away, especially after you've just been sacked in the previous play.
Keep the throttle down.
Number 10, looking to pass, lines up with five wide receivers.
They don't get nothing.
Pressure coming. They reached him just as he was throwing.
This guy's so strong, he was able to get that pass away.
And this should be the last play of the half.
On the 38-yard line.
Look, look. The
only one man back.
Watch your eyes. Red.
Looking for the long completion.
Ooh,
nearly picked off. Going into halftime, the score is 10-7. There. Butler will be kicking off. Good distance. From the three. Bryant finds an open area on the return and brings it back to the 30. First and 10.
Start the drive at the 30-yard line. First and 10.
Dropping back to pass on first down. Gets rid of
it.
Broken up.
He did a nice job of getting off the line and getting into his pass pattern. But he had the ball bounce right off his fingertips.
Second and 10. Ball on the 30-yard line.
The Bears line up in a 4-3. Hand it off to the back. Singletary is there for the tackle at the 39-yard line. Now let's have a look at what our runners have done up to this point. Ball on their own 39.
Ball on the 39-yard line.
Foreman lines up behind his fullback in the eye. Number 45 comes up to make the play at the 45-yard line. And he was able to create a lot of space on that run, John.
Well, it started with some good blocking. And when he got through there, he turned upfield, and they weren't in position to tackle him.
Ball on the 45-yard line.
You're there.
The Bears come out on the 46. Hands it off. He's brought down behind the line for a short loss. Just no room to run on that play.
When defense comes out with that many guys up in the line of scrimmage, it's going to take a heck of a job from the offensive line to be able to open up any holes for the back.
Ball on their own 45.
Ball on the 45-yard line.
Yeah, you see me. There we go, dude.
46 defense in this time.
74.
From the start.
Under pressure, launches this one to the left. And he lets it slip out of his grasp. Missed opportunity right there. clear on the numbers when it comes to third down conversions.
Let's go, boys!
Chicago comes out in a dime package. With the pass, nearly intercepted. Singletary had his hands up.
I think he was invisible out there. Wasn't even seen. That's a break for the offense.
Gentry sets up to run back the punt. This one goes out of bounds.
First and 10. Ball on the 18-yard line.
Everything, everything you got.
The Vikings come out in a 4-3. They're blitzing. Gets away the off-balance throw. Number 90 makes the play at the 21-yard line.
Passing on first down is a way of keeping the defense off balance. If you're successful, it could set up big runs on first down or any typical passing situation.
So a pickup of maybe three.
There we go, baby, rock and roll. Let's go.
The Vikings line up in a 4-3. Looking upfield. Kraft is there on the stop at the 35. Good gain on the ground gives them what they needed for a first.
That's just good running. They sent a couple of blitzes in to try and stop him in the backfield, but he just broke free and got past the sticks for a first down.
It's first and 10.
Ball on the 35-yard line.
Great shoot.
Minnesota using three linebackers. They'll spot this one at the 41.
The best backs in the league average 4 to 5 yards a carry. But there are a lot of things that go into a successful running game. You got to have good play calling, good blocking up front, and a back that can take advantage when he sees the opening.
Ball on their own 41.
Ball on the 41-yard line.
The Vikings come out in the quarter defense. Throwing. The wide receiver has it. Number 38 comes up to make the play at the 46-yard line. Excellent recognition by the receiver, reading the coverage and adjusting his route accordingly.
Option routes are receiving routes designed to take advantage of the coverage. It's up to both the receiver and the quarterback to make the same read. If the receiver reads zone, but the quarterback reads man, you can see passes going right to the defender.
Receives the handoff. He's going for it all. There. Touchdown, Chicago. Hey, is the injured player on the field? He'll be coming out for this next play, so we'll find out what the story is. Butler comes in to attempt the point after. The extra point attempt is good. That's 17 unanswered points.
They just can't seem to stop them.
From the 2-yard line.
This is where you want to respond quickly, or this could turn into a battle for field position.
First and 10.
Keep the throttle down.
Play football.
Number 10 starts out of the shotgun. Good protection. He held on to it too long.
He was being patient, waiting for something to happen.
Whap! Now they're looking at second and long after the sack. So an update now on the injury. It doesn't appear to be anything serious, and his return is probable. incomplete. They won the battle at the line of scrimmage and forced a bad throw.
Every quarterback needs a little time to look over the field. There we saw a defense who wasn't given any time at all.
Third and long. Ball on the 22-yard line.
I think this defense looks forward to these third down situations because they've been stopping them today.
Gets pulled down from behind.
I'm sure the coach has some concern as they haven't been able to block this guy all game.
So three and out, and they'll line up to punt. Took his eyes off the ball, and it's up for grabs. The Vikings grab the live ball. They give it right back to them after the fumble on the punt return.
I'll tell you, when you're returning a punt, your number one priority is to hold on to the ball. And your defense just made a good stand.
First and ten.
The offense is set to come in and make something happen. You do something like that.
Hey, watch the screen. The Bears come out on the 46. They're coming with the blitz. Gets the pass off. He's lucky he got that one off, John. The defense brought everyone on the blitz.
They just went after the quarterback, but his quick release allowed him to escape a sack.
Second and ten. Ball on the 39-yard line.
Watch out. Get it up.
Chicago comes out with eight guys in the box. Looking upfield. Look at that. Number 45 is there on the stop. And now our viewers can see how successful each team's main running threat has been today.
For a place to run, but all those places were filled up with guys waiting to tackle him.
Second and nine.
Ball on the 27-yard line.
The Bears come out in a nickel package. Phillips comes up to make the play at the 29-yard line. Phillips is getting up very slowly. It looks like he'll head toward the sideline, and we'll get you an injury report as quickly as possible. To get the first down, they have to reach the 18-yard line.
Not today.
A lineup of six defensive backs. Closing in. They can't block anybody. How do you give up nine sacks? A field goal here brings them within a touchdown. Cox got all of it, and the field goal is good.
He's one of those guys who really works hard at what he does. And you can see that hard work paying off when you make a kick like this one.
Nice kick. Plenty of distance. From the 2-yard line. Couldn't stop them from getting into the end zone the last time out. So at the end of the third quarter, the score is 17-10.
The Bears, 17. The Vikings, 10.
And we'll start the fourth quarter.
They'll
first and 10
at the 32-yard line. First and 10.
Let's go! Score!
going to the right. Number 90 comes up to make the play. Gentry is able to get a yard or two on the toss. It's second down and 9 to go.
From the start.
The Vikings with a four-man front.
Let's go, boys.
Looking for the long completion. And he fails to hang on to that pass.
The quarterback did a great job of getting some air under that pass, hitting his guy right in the hand. It just looked like he might have lost a little focus as he tried to bring that pass in.
Phillips is back in there after getting taken out with an injury earlier. The Vikings come out in a nickel factor. Kraus makes the stop at the 42. So on the blitz, they can't get to the ball carrier until it's too late.
And when you're blitzing to stop the run, the idea is bringing more guys and the offense can block. We also got to cut off the lanes and gaps that he can use to escape out of the backfield. That just didn't happen here.
Gentry, the lone back. Pressure gets the pass off. This pass is incomplete. McKinnon is the injured player on the field. He'll be coming out for this next play, so we'll find out what the story is.
Second and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line.
Minnesota comes out in a 4-3. Pressure coming. Gets rid of it. Almost picked off. Deep throw, nearly picked off.
When you've got a receiver who wins a lot of jump ball situations, you've got to throw it deep to him. That time, the defender got the better jump.
McKinnon returns from being injured. And we can attribute this lead to their ability to convert on third down. Page comes up to make the play at the 47. He played it safe, stayed on the ground, nothing doing. Number 8 is ready to punt this one away. Number 42 into return. Won't take a chance trying to return this one.
Down by a touchdown, going on offense, time running out. It doesn't get a whole heck of a lot better than this.
Hey, was taken out earlier with a minor injury, but now returns to the game. Chicago comes out in their nickel package. Marshall records the tackle at the 27-yard line. A lot of success attacking that defense with the run.
They showed confidence in him by staying with the run, even though the defense came up in the 46, and it really paid off.
Second and 3. Ball on the 27-yard line.
You get.
They give it to the halfback. A solid tackle in the open field by Richardson.
Hey, if you can keep running the ball in the fourth quarter as you're playing catch-up, that's an advantage that you have over the defense because it keeps them off balance.
Hey, let's go one deep.
Cross play to the right. Now that's a stiff one. Number 22 stops him at the 48-yard line. Foreman runs off tackle for a gain of a couple. Full at about midfield.
Ball on the 48-yard line.
Gets the call. McMichael makes the tackle at the 42-yard line. Foreman has gained enough for another first down, his second of the drive.
First and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line.
Chicago lines up in the 46. Going long. jumps and makes the catch. Tough to cover someone one-on-one who can leap like that. Great effort. Cox will tie it up here in the fourth quarter by converting this extra point. The point after is good. The game is tied, but still a lot of time left.
The strategy of the NFL shows itself right here. Anyone who thinks football is just a bunch of guys hitting each other, well, pay attention to the next few minutes.
Sends it sailing. From the two. Keeps his feet moving.
This is just how the coach likes to play. Keep it close until the end, then put something together with your last drive to come away with the win. Now it's up to the offense to close this one out.
Almost at the 2-minute mark now. Only one man back on the call with the throw. Pass ball's incomplete.
Hey, put his helmet in there, and he made contact with the ball.
Number 58 had the coverage on the play. Two-minute warning coming up.
On the 22-yard line.
Only one man in the backfield.
Let's turn it up, D.
Pushes it out to the left. Can't bring him in. And he stopped at the 34. That's the fourth stop he's made today.
This is a great block. Watch here. He just barrels into the defender, taking him right off the turf. Now that is a textbook block right there.
Brought down behind the line for a short loss. So after that run, we can see how the two main threats on the ground have fared so far. Second and long.
Ball on the 31-yard line.
Keep moving.
The Vikings come out in a 4-3. Dropping back with the throw. Goes up, makes the catch. The 40, the 20, the 10. Touchdown, Bears.
When you get this kind of execution, you got a great chance of making a big play. Watch it here as everyone takes care of their assignment. The pass is thrown where the receiver can make the best play in the ball. And it's 6 points.
The extra point attempt is good. The Bears have moved into position for the victory as they go up by a touchdown with less than 2 minutes remaining.
Yeah, they did everything right. But now they have to play great defense to keep them out of the end zone.
Butler is just about ready to kick this one away. He got all of that one. From the 4-yard line.
This is why you practice these situations again and again. Because this is for the game, and a 2-minute drill is all about execution. There's no time for mistakes.
First and 10.
Start the drive at the 20-yard line. First and 10.
Safety run!
Set! Let's go!
Oh.
Gets rid of it. Broken up.
Marshall,
who's there on the coverage?
Marshall on the coverage. Second and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line.
Get it up! Let's go now.
Chicago comes out in their nickel package.
Hold the look!
Throwing. And he hits his target. Number 10, clearly regarded as one of the most accurate passers in the league, and with passes like that, you know why.
Yeah, you know what? When he lets it go, he's not trying to throw it in the direction of the receiver. He's trying to hit him right on the hand, put the ball right at their fingertips, and most of the time he does it. This team has to start converting on third down if they're going to be successful.
Rosen, he was tipped.
And there's not one wide receiver who can ever claim that he's never dropped a pass. It's just part of the game.
Big play, baby.
Carroll, the man in motion. A little misdirection. And he stopped at the 30. He got in there and made the tackle, his fourth of the game. That's a big stop by the defense on fourth down as they take over possession late in the game with a one-touchdown advantage. It's first and 10. Minnesota goes with a four-man front. They give it to the halfback. Takes advantage of a little daylight. Picks up 3 yards.
Second and 7. Ball on the 27-yard line.
Watch the screen! Hey, watch the screen!
Minnesota using 3 linebackers. Number 50 is there for the tackle at the 20. They kept his legs moving, gets 7 hard-earned yards. The 20-yard line would net them a first down here on this third down play. They'll make this a 2-possession game if they get into the end zone on this drive. They're just inside the 20. Fullback handoff. Hurdles the defender. Bryant is there on the stop at the 15.
This is tough running here. Let's watch him as he gets through right here. And he breaks a tackle and keeps moving forward. I tell you, this guy's hard to bring down.
He'll just take a knee.
Watch out.
No more, fellas. Tackle. Come on. All on us, y'all.
And there's the kneel down by the quarterback.
Thank you for attending today's ball game. Please drive home safely.